Hi, good evening, everyone. Hopefully, we will have people joining us soon. I'm gonna wait a little bit more to see a little, I don't know, some eyes there. One, two, three. For the moment, not. Okay, I'm gonna wait a little bit more. Tonight, I'm gonna go with some very beautiful colors. Hi, my director, video director says that I have already some eyes watching me. Hello, good evening. I'm Elle from Elle Furniture, and I'm a content creator for Dixie Belle since May this year. It's the first time when I'm going live, so cheer up. And I really hope that the project that I'm starting tonight, I hope you will like it. I chose some very special colors, colors that I really love working with. And I those that are following me, my Instagram and my Facebook, they know that I used quite a lot of times this combination. So we have this piece of furniture here, which is looks like it's real wood, but it's not. It's a press board, and these ornaments are the only real wood on this furniture, and of course they are glued in here. It was super dirty, and I'm sorry I washed it outside the camera because this would have been let's say a good successful story, how to clean a furniture with white lining. I washed it over 1 hour. It's been it stayed in a home where probably people smoked because it was really yellow. And initially I thought it's a bleeder, and I was like, how can it be a bleeder? Because this is not real wood. So anyway, it's clean now. Finally, I washed it, as I said, about an hour. And now it's ready to be painted. And we are gonna use, as I said, some of my favorite colors because I love all the colors from Dixie Belle, but these are, let's say, on the top five. I'm gonna go on the low part of the furniture with the midnight sky. And then my plan. Now let's see how we will end up with it. I want to go peacock for this area here. And then I want to go to this super, super sweet blue, which is called Dixie Blue. Dixie Belle Blue. Dixie Belle Blue. So I have a question. Oh, I have a question, please.
Lisa is asking, where are
Hi,
you located
Lisa.
at?
Sorry?
Where are you located at?
Oh, I'm in Europe, on the border of Germany with Luxembourg. It's a very beautiful area with a lot of wineries. So, a lot of hills. It's a very beautiful area. The only problem is that it's always cold and raining in here. So, yeah. So, we need for blending, of course, we need Mr. Bottle. We cannot survive without Mr. Bottle. And because I'm gonna use three colors, I will go with three different clean mini brushes. They're all clean. And what else I'm gonna need? I'm gonna need some clean microfiber cloth. These are a little wet because when I'm gonna do the actual blending, you will see me all the time coming and cleaning my brush, the extra quantity of paint, because with this clean brush, the oval medium, I'm gonna come and I'm gonna blend the colors together. And to see how heavily used is this one, I will show you these actually are the same brushes. Yeah, so this is also oval medium, but this one is heavily used and this one is brand new. I just wanted to show how they become after, I don't know, 3 months of doing blend. Okay, so that's all we need for such a project. I chose these colors, as I said, because I love them and also because they are super easy to be blended. Why? Because they have the same base of colors. So they are both, all the three of us, they are blue. And you will see that it's really very easy to blend these colors. So let's get started. And usually I start with the dark colors and with the low part of the furniture, especially for the first hand. And then for the second hand, I may start doing from top to down, but now let's start like this. And what we need to do is to take a little bit of water and just dump. How do you say dump? I don't know. Damp. Yeah, please excuse my English. My husband is fluent in English. I'm not, and he's always making fun of me. Okay. So if you have questions, my dear husband is here with me, and he's gonna read the questions, and he will answer to you, or I will answer to you. Sorry. Okay. In between coats, I always keep the brushes. You will see. I put them on. This is a little bit wet, and after I use them, I always keep them like this, so that I will not get the paint dry. Okay. No more questions? Oh, come on. We don't want to take, and we don't want to load the brush too much with too much paint. So we just go light. And on the first coat, usually I, like I guess all the artists are doing the same, I don't want to have a perfect coverage. I just want to put the colors on the furniture, see how it's gonna look like. And then on the second coat, I'm gonna come and I'm gonna spend more time mixing better and so on and so forth. And what I also do now, I will not take the drawers out, but for the second coat, I will take the drawers out and I will also come in here in detail, and I will put the paint everywhere around the furniture. But right now I just want to get an idea of how they are gonna look. So this is the midnight sky, which is a very dark blue gray, let's say. And what I also do, I overlap the colors. Yeah, so I'm gonna stop using this one, as I said, and I keep it in the wet microfiber cloth. Okay. You see, I really take very small amount of paint. Okay, the chief says that you cannot see very well because I'm staying and I'm occupying the television. How many viewers I have? Wow, you're kidding, really? Oh my gosh, 27 people, oh my gosh. Okay, and now I take the clean microfiber, the clean brush, and barely touching the furniture. This is very important to have to just feather the furniture. It's really, really important. Don't put pressure on the brush. So it's like this, and we just come and very easily touch the furniture. I will ask my husband, not now, but maybe when I'm coming here, to bring the camera to you closer so that you can see how I do it closer.
Cindy says hello from New Hampshire.
Hey, Cindy. Hello. Thank you for watching, girls and boys. Thank you so much. I'm super nervous. I'm super nervous. You have no idea how nervous I was. I was like, please go 5 minutes before. Let's make sure that everything is okay. Yeah. Wow, Spain. We love Spain. Hola, hello. Thank you for coming, girls. Thank you so much. It's so super important for me. I was afraid. I was like, oh my gosh, what if I'm gonna be alone? What's gonna happen? And my husband said, no worries, I will ask you questions. Ah. Yeah, so just the first hand, the first coat, not the first hand, I know. The first coat we really don't want to spend too much time on overdoing things. And Bali, please tell me if you don't see. It's kind of okay. Yeah, it's not so easy to paint here. Maybe I will just leave this part behind, and I will go and I will start working up because I really wanted to see. So, as I was telling you in the beginning of the live, it's really very important to start blending with colors that not necessarily that are close to each other, like I don't know, yellow with the white or light pink with dark pink. But it's very important to go with colors from the same family of color. That's how I call family of color. I don't know if that's the word. I have no idea. But yeah, so don't try to blend, especially in the beginning. If you are a beginner, don't try to blend red with blue. Yeah, because it's going to be very difficult for everyone. Even the experienced artists may have issues to mix such contrastant colors. I don't know if it's the word. So for those that don't know, I'm not my English is not my mother language, so don't be very hard on me. I try my best to speak something that people can understand.
Cindy said that's a beautiful piece of furniture.
Yeah, it's not real wood. I was saying in the beginning of the video, it's not real wood. The only real wood on this furniture are these ornaments. That's the only real wood. The rest is just prefabricated boards, or I don't know how you call. By the way, how do you call this? Huh? Prefab. Okay. Okay, so as you could see so
Yeah,
far.
Elizabeth says hi from New Jersey, and
Hi.
Nancy, hi from Maryland.
Hello, girls. Hello. Good evening, or not good evening. I think in America it's still good afternoon. So until now I just cleaned the, how do you call this? Lid. Yeah. So that's the amount of paint I used for this drawer. Only the paint from the lid. Now I'm going to the real, to the real. Huh? This is what? If that's the lid, that one with what? So, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about me. I started to paint furniture 2 years ago. What happened was that even today I still work. I have a full-time job. So, painting is really only my let's say my hobby. I like doing this all the time. It's the moment when I'm really connected with myself. I love painting furniture, and I try to learn a lot, and I learned a lot watching videos before I started to actually touch a brush. What I've done, I watched. I think I don't overreact when I say I watched millions of hours of YouTube tutorials from everybody. And when I started to actually paint, Of course, I understood that it's not that easy as it looks, but also I understood finally what the artists that I was following, they were what they were saying, that this is the most relaxing activity that someone can do, and is really true. And normally as a person I'm super energetic and I cannot stay in one place more than 5 minutes. I always need to move and to do things, but when I paint I can stay here all night long, so I don't have to go anywhere just to paint. Yeah, so barely touching the furniture and bringing the colors into each other. It has lots of ornaments and I have to pay attention. So I will take out the drawers for when I place and the colors, and when I'm happy with the with how they look, then I will take out the drawers and I will also paint under in between the drawer and the furniture itself. Again, don't put too much paint on the brush. It's very important to have, it's better take more often paint and then load more often the brush with paint rather than have too much here, because then when you want to start the blending, it will be very difficult for you to make the blend itself if you have too much paint.
Says, hello, from
hello, hello Noreen. Nice name. Very nice and very unique. So are you, all of you, are you already painting, or you just you are just thinking to start? I would really like to know your stories, girls. It's interesting how this passion is bringing together people from all over the world, literally from all over the world. It's really nice, and I met several amazing people since I started to paint furniture, and I learned so many things. Each artist that I follow, I don't know, was a teacher for me, and I respect each of them so much. And we have so many amazing artists working with the Dixie Belle products. We have amazing, talented brand ambassadors. We are super lucky to have such great teachers.
Casey says greetings from South Carolina.
Hello, hello, hello to you. Thank you for watching. What do you think, girls? How does it look on the screen? Is it nice? Starts to look nice. I want to place also this one, the Dixie Belle blue, but I don't know how to go or where to start applying it. I really don't know.
Heather says hi from Florida. Love your accent.
Thank you. Thank you. You are so cute. Thank you. Yeah, I sound a little Russian. By the way, I'm Romanian. So originally, I'm from Romania. We moved here to work in Luxembourg in 2015, maybe, I think. 2015, yeah, I did. My husband moved earlier. And yeah, it's not easy. Because as I told you, the biggest problem here, I mean, the region is beautiful. We have, I'm trying the blue, the baby blue. I don't know, the Dixie Belle blue. I don't know if I'm going to use it eventually, because I really like how this is mixing together. But I want to use this blue too. So let's see. Let's see what we get.
Judy says hi from Dallas.
Hello. Oh, it's not about the courage. It's just take any furniture that you don't like in your home and just play with it. And it, what is very important from my point of view, I'm telling you how I learned, because I told you at the beginning of the video, I started to do this about 2 years ago. And because I don't do it as a job, I do it as a hobby because I have already a job, a full-time job. So I don't have too much time to work. But what I've done, I watched the videos wishing to learn. So I did not watch the video only like to watch a video. I was literally stopping the image on Brandy. I remember Brandy when she was doing blending, I was stopping the video and I was turning it, I was putting it back 10 seconds, and I was literally watching like this Brandy's hands to see how she touches the furniture, how she's doing it. Yeah, so it's very important when you start watching tutorials or lives, just look at what happens with the hand of the artist that is doing the tutorial. It's very important.
Can she suggest maybe do the lightest blue or the spot where the hardware would go? So
yeah, only in the middle. Yeah. Let's try. Let's play. In the end, the first hand. This is the beauty of painting furniture, especially when you apply the first coat. You can do with the second coat or third, whatever you want. So you can go unlimited.
Casey also says that this blend makes me want a blue raspberry popsicle.
Yeah. Yeah, that's nice. Where are you going? Hello, my translator left. Girls, he left me alone with you. Yeah, I don't remember. Who said to put the light blue here? It's a thank you. You saved my evening. It's amazing. Look, it's really amazing. Thank you. What a great idea. Thank you. Yeah, that's what this piece needs. Exactly, this is what it needs. Amazing. I'm not missing so much the furniture because, as I said, we live in the North Pole. So in here, it's super chilly and it's humidity and it's ugly weather. And so it's not really not that warm in here. So I don't need to miss the furniture too much. Yeah, so barely touching the furniture. Just very, very lightly playing here and creating this puff, 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 puff gesture. And cleaning the brush. And puffing again. And then we return a little bit with Peacock here because I don't.
Susan says hello from Harrison.
Hello, Susan. Thanks for watching. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for watching. I mean, it's amazing. I thought I'm going to have one viewer, my husband. And he's not even watching, exactly. Yeah, so that's the way it should look. I love it. Thank you again for the idea. Thank you. Amazing.
Steve says hello from New York.
Oh, New York. What a beautiful place. Yeah, hello from Luxembourg. It's not raining, but it's going to start raining soon. So we did not have a summer, actually, this year. It's been, we had a few days of summer in the end of May. And then it rained nonstop. We had floods. That's how you say? Floods? Okay, we had floods. But it was really bad. I mean, people lost their homes and cars. And it was really a natural disaster. It was raining nonstop for 2 weeks. Nonstop. Night, day, raining like cats and dogs. Oh my gosh, this piece is so beautiful. And I remembered about it when I saw Brandy's latest video. I don't know if you noticed, she made a set of three pieces. Today, I think she launched on her YouTube already the second one. She made a set, but without keeping the same color. She blended, of course. She blended. She's the queen. And she made one, she made it blue, one she made it green, and the other one she made it, I think, kind of flamingo, if I'm right. I don't know, I don't remember, because I didn't have time to watch yet the video. I know she releases it today or tomorrow. And I realized that when I saw her pieces, I realized that, oh my gosh, I have a piece that is super similar to Brandy. So why not I should do that piece? So that's how I got in here.
This is asking if that is the best damn brush.
No. This one, I showed it in the beginning. This one is the oval medium. And it is, naturally, it's not so big. I mean, this is what it became after using it for, I think I'm using this for over 3-4 months, and this is how it became. And originally it was like this. I mean, this, if you believe or not, is the same brush, but this one has been killed. Like, I think probably I've done around 20 pieces with this. So that's why.
And that one?
Those ones are the mini. The mini from Dixie Belle. I cannot live without these brushes. I mean, these are the brushes. So look at this difference, yeah? Yeah. Very good brushes. So for blending, I know that there are also, I also received one Best Dang. But I didn't use it for this purpose. Why? For blending, because I like to have a smooth finish. And natural bristles, how do you call, babe? Natural bristles, they leave marks on the furniture. And I don't like that. There are artists that are doing it, if you want to create a texture, then definitely that's the best solution. But I don't want that. I want to have a smooth finish. So I will go for synthetic brushes. Okay, so this is continuing to apply the. I will go on the same. Now I don't want to overload and overplay the surface. I'm gonna leave it like this, and for the second coat, I will go and I will apply this light. Blue in the middle also for these two drawers. And thank you again for giving me the idea. It's amazing. It looks super great, super great. Yeah, so what I was telling you? I was telling you about how I started to paint, yeah? And how I, yeah, exactly. And how I was watching thousands of videos, and that's how I got courage to start painting. And when I started to paint, of course I realized it's not that easy as it looks, but I was surprised that I knew what I had to do from the very first day when I touched the brush. So because I watched very carefully, I did not miss any video of the artist that I was following. I watched all the videos that they posted from the beginning. I was actually stalking them. Stalking, that's how you say? I was a stalker, yeah. I was a stalker. I was stalking them. So watching video after video after video after video, non-stop watching and learning and trying to understand and watching their hands and how they were placing the paint and where and in what way. Yeah, that's important. I really like it. I really like how it comes out. It's super, super adorable. And this light in the middle, oh my gosh, it's so great. Okay. So how is everyone? What are you doing? How are you painting? Are you doing this as a job or also like me as a hobby? A hobby. It became slowly the main job. I think it was a hobby until last year. Now it's almost a job, but it's a job that I love, so it's not actually a job. No more questions? Nobody asks me anything. Come on, girls. Ask me.
Judy says hello, Anne from St. Louis.
Hello, hello.
I love your color combination, and I'm new to this kind of painting, and I appreciate you doing the live demo.
Yeah.
What do you do with your pieces after you paint them?
Oh, well, it depends. Usually I sell them. but I also do a lot of furniture for friends, and now I'm working on I found some ladies that are gonna open a fashion store in Luxembourg, and they said that they would love to have their reception done by me and some other furniture and so on and so forth. And then we commonly came with the idea that because the space is quite big, why am I not doing more pieces and actually sell those pieces in the store, which sounds really amazing. I think that's gonna be the next step and the next I don't know, whatever. It's another story. And so if that's gonna happen, then I will sell the pieces in the store. So yeah, I'm selling the pieces, most of them. And I also do for myself because I think over 90% of the furniture that I have in our home is done by me. So some of them are still the original painted ones, but most of them I repainted because, of course, now I don't like what I was doing 2 years ago, and I think that now I'm doing it better, and I learned blending. So of course I want to have all the pieces blended.
Sue says I'm still a stalker in getting my courage.
Yeah. Do that because that's the way to do. I mean, that's really the way to do. Be a stalker.
Nancy asks, is the dark color black?
No, it's not black. It's midnight sky. It's in a very dark blue, grayish, exactly as the name, a sky in the midnight. It's really that color, dark.
You mentioned Dixibel. Is that the brand you use?
Yes.
Do you mix different paint brands?
No. Now, because... Now I'm on a brand ambassador for Dixibel, a content creator for me. They're all the same, yeah. For Dixibel, so I'm using, of course, their products, but I am this because I believe in their product, and I tried several other brands before. I'm not gonna say that others are not good, but they are not. Let's say they're not my style as much as the Dixie Belle paints are, because they are very, Dixie Belle paints are very, how to say, very creamy. They are really having a very creamy texture, and they are very flexible when it comes about blending. They dry in a way that they don't become sticky. And I like to make a comparison. I'm saying that Dixie Belle paints, compared to other brands that I tried, is like the butter when you leave it outside on the table for an hour, and when you take, and compared to the one that you take directly from the fridge, it's that difference. Yeah, so it's super creamy, and it really goes very smooth, as you can see in here. So it really doesn't dry sticky. This is the best part of the Dixie Belle paint. So I love these paints. I love it.
Trudy says, good luck with your new adventure. Ah.
Yeah, I can't wait. I mean, that's a dream. That's really for everyone, to sell your product in a store where the pieces are respected. I really don't like to sell my pieces on marketplace, and thanks God, I don't have to sell my painting, my product on my furniture on marketplace since quite a while, because I'm mostly doing commission pieces. But I think putting this kind of furniture on marketplace, it's like trying to sell on marketplace Ferrari. This is what I think. I mean, after you work maybe 10, 20, 15 hours on a piece, to have someone to come and try to, I don't know, to get the piece not for the real value of the piece, I think it's really a pity. And I know that in the United States, this delivery in between states, it's much easier, and you can find you can sell your pieces on Etsy, and this is good, because you can really get the real value of the furniture back. But in Europe, because we are multiple countries, we are not one country, we are one continent with different countries. So then the transportation between countries, it's impossible. If I wanted and I delivered a piece in France and
in the UK.
No, that UK is another story. No, but the one in France, I delivered with 180 euro, you remember? And I had to, and that was the cheapest that I could find. So I got, I think, 200 euro I paid I got for the furniture itself, and then I had to pay 180 for the transportation. The buyer was okay, and he said, yeah, I will pay the transportation, but there are not so many buyers that want to pay so much money for transportation. So in Europe, selling in other countries, it's really not an option. So unfortunately, this is the reality for Europe. So having a store, it's really a good thing. But on the other hand, Luxembourg is a very expensive country and city, and renting one store for yourself, it makes no sense. It's one little store of maybe 40 square meters. I don't know how much that should be in the US meter. You don't have meters. Okay, 500 feet, yeah, for so square feet. So for that, we have to pay around 3,000 euro the rent. So it's insane. It makes no sense. Yeah, so in here it's not yet dry, so I will not go now on that. What I think I want to do is to, because I want to let it dry now, and I want to turn the piece with the on the side, and then to paint the this side, so that you can see also a little bit better the blending on a flat surface, which is really different. It's more, for me, even if everybody says that it's more difficult to blend on molding, for me it's easier. I don't know why, probably because I tried so many times that, I don't know, somehow I made it work. But yeah, so let's switch the furniture and let me show you the side. No, I can do it. Only tell me if the people will be able to see it well. It's fine?
Yeah.
Okay, so then we continue and we do the side. And while I'm telling my husband how much I love him, if he washes my cloth, please, thank you. I love you. I appreciate you. No, you can, come on. Ah, so okay. Like this?
Yes.
Like that? Okay, okay. Okay, let me get a little bit of water and then I will, if I get questions, my husband will come and he will read it. He read them in 1 minute. Okay. So let's continue. Midnight sky again. I'm repeating the colors. And peacock, one of my favorite combination. And I'm gonna try to use also for this side, I'm gonna try to use also the Dixie Belle blue somewhere in the middle. I think, I hope, I don't know. I'm an artist in La La Land and I always change my mind. So, and from time to time, especially if I stay and I don't use the brushes for, I don't know, a few minutes, as I said, I keep them on a wet microfiber cloth and I spray a little bit of water just to make sure that the paint won't dry. As I said, it's really not very warm in here. It's actually quite cold. So that drying is not going to happen. I had this veneer here is broken, was broken, and I put a little bit of mud from Dixie Belle. Thank you. And now it's dry and I'm going to sand it. I have a very low abrasive sponge here. It's from Dixie Belle also. It's a small sponge which has a very light abrasive. I think it's around, probably it should be 220 or at least 220.
Same here in Italy regarding the price. They all want cheap or better for free.
Exactly.
And she also said my accent is in Romanian.
Oh, yes. Yeah, because we, the French and the Italian, we have the same accent in English. It's impossible for people not to recognize us. Yes, hello from Italy. Hello. Yeah, so I put here some mud, Dixie Belle mud, and I repaired the varnish, which was a little bit broken. Under, I put a little bit of glue, wood glue. And now I'm lightly sanding just to make sure that I will not have any imperfection on the paint. That's all you need when you have broken veneer or varnish. I don't even know which is the difference between varnish and veneer in English. In my language, I know the difference, but in English, I don't know. So this is varnish, veneer, it's the same. Is it? Isn't it? No, it's not. Yeah, my husband, he speaks better English than me, but he doesn't paint better than me, so sorry for you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm also Romanian colleagues in Italy.
Ah, hey, bună, bine ai venit, welcome. Yeah, so we have a very cute accent. I would say cute. I think we are cute. Right? I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to the ladies and gentlemen that are watching me. By the way, how many people are watching?
56.
Oh my gosh, that's too much. Come on, really? Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for joining. I was really afraid that I will do this alone with my husband. But thanks to you, I'm not. So, and by the way, what I also do when I paint, I also paint the back. Even if I wash the piece perfectly, what happens in most of the times is that I think that, it's, first of all, I think it's not finished. When I see the back not painted, I'm like, this piece is not finished. It doesn't look finished. And besides this, at least here in Europe, I don't know how it's in the United States or on other continents, but in here, people usually, I mean, they of course, most of the furniture stay on the wall, but you will see very often in Europe that people put a dresser like this in the middle of the room, just, I don't know, somewhere on the corner. They make all kinds of things, and so having the furniture painted also on the back, I think it gives more value to the furniture. And what else I also do, I always do the interiors. If the drawers are very damaged, then I will paint the drawers, and on the bottom, I will always place either silk paper or decoupage paper or something like that, because I really like people to have the, you know, the feeling that they are the first ones that are using that drawer. I really want them to feel comfortable, that they know that inside that drawer was not something nasty or I don't know. So I always do the back and the interior of the drawers. So I'm overlapping the colors here always. I go over one on top of the others so that I make sure that I have a good space for the paint to mix.
Dana is asking, what's your business page? Because it's the first time when I see
you. I'm L Furniture on all the social medias, on Instagram, on Facebook, on YouTube, on TikTok. But on TikTok, my son is the one that is making the videos, and on YouTube is my dear husband who is making the videos. So I don't have the merit for those beautiful videos that you are watching. I'm in the La La Land. I'm the artist, and they are the supporters of the artist. So I go inside the lighter blue, and then I go outside, and then I go inside, and then I go outside, and I do this many times, and I barely touch the furniture. I really do not put pressure on the brush almost at all. I just leave it feathering. Brandy is saying, I'm feathering. I told you, I'm a stalker. I've been a stalker, and I'm a stalker for this. Oh gosh, thank you. Thank you so much for watching. You really encourage me to come back on the page and have other videos too. I really hope I entertain you, and I hope that you learn something, and I hope that you get the guts to start painting, because this is such a beautiful thing to do, and it gives so much relaxation. And no matter how sad you are or how, I don't know, discouraged by life, always going into painting, it's gonna relax you. And how does it look? Because you see on the face, on the front, you don't see, especially on the first hand, you really don't see it too much because of those lot of moldings. But in here you can see. So how is it? How does it look? Is it beautiful? I think it's nice. I think it's nicey. Not nice, nicey. But anyway, it's the first coat, yeah? So we will make it better next coat. I avoid to say next hand. You know, in our language, next coat, we always say next hand. So that's why I if you hear me saying also in my YouTube second hand of paint, that doesn't mean paint from the second hand. It means just the second coat. Yeah, so second hand for me is second coat. So don't be hard on me. In here, the veneer, whatever, it's broken in here. It's not broken, actually. I cannot repair it because it has a very big hole, like on the whole. I didn't see this. I will see. Hopefully, I can fix it. Eventually.
Karamida says, hi, it's the first time I watch you.
Yes, it's the first time. Hey, hello, Portugal, our brothers in language and our friends and brothers. Our languages are very similar, Latin languages. Yeah, this one is a little bit thicker. So it needs a little bit of water. And I am going a little bit more into the peacock in here. And don't worry, because I will get back with the peacock. A little bit more of peacock, which is such a lovely color. I love this color. So we just want to put the layers of paint. We don't want to make anything perfect. Anyway, it will get better. Don't worry. It's not going to stay like this. Please don't worry. It's going to be nicer. You will see. And now starts the blending. It's not good or right. I think I don't like people that are, I don't know, judging others that, oh, that is done worse or better. Or no, I think it's just so much. It is really related to the artist and to the craziness that he finds, the logic that he finds to come and to blend or to paint. And I think each artist has its or his or her value. And yeah, so if you don't click with my style of blending, it's fine. Maybe you will click with another artist's way of blending. It's very important to try more techniques from more artists and to see which one fits you, because there are people that are having, let's say, a heavy hand. It's not something bad. It's just that it's different from me. I can be soft-handed. But if you are not, then definitely this feathering will not click with you. So you have to find other ways to do the blending. And then probably the blending done with the best best dang. I always forget that the name of that a big brush. Yeah, so that may also be an option. And it's super nice. And the blending, I've seen some amazing pieces done with that brush. And they look amazing because they get a little bit moody. So the blending gets moody, and it's really a very nice blending. I love it, but I don't know how to make it. I cannot do it. I also didn't try, but I don't think I will be able to do it. So just try more techniques. It's very important to see which one you click with. And what I'm doing now, I go all kinds of directions. I will not try to get a perfect blend on this coat, definitely. But I really want to have the colors mixed very well, because then if I don't do it on the second coat, it will be much difficult for me to mix and to make the mix of the colors.
Donuts explică că vanilia este lemn, pentru că de la care ai pus-o peste lemn și varnish este lacul. Ce te-am explicat
Ah,
100 de ori, dar nu ai înțeles.
okay, thank you. So, yeah.
Caramita says, beautiful colors indeed. Karen is watching from Sweden.
Oh, hello from Sweden, brothers. For the weather, we have the same cold weather, I think. So, even if it looked a mess in the beginning, now starts to.
Nancy's is asking, you paint with a flat brush and blend with a round?
Yes, I'm painting. I apply the paint with the mini. Oh, this one is super old and super dirty. It's the mini from Dixie Belle. These are the best for me, at least, to apply the furniture with, the paint with. And then I come and I make the blending itself with a clean medium oval from also from Dixie Belle. And probably you joined a little bit later, but I will show you what I showed already to the people. This is the same brush with this. So they are the same brushes, only that this is new and this is over heavily used to do the blending. So because I don't put a lot of pressure on the furniture, but when I clean it, because I want to make it sure to make sure that I don't mix the colors where I don't want to mix the colors, I come and I really kill it. I when I clean it, I really kill it. Like this killing. So of course it changes the shape, but I try to keep it always super clean. Yeah, so for the first hand, I think, okay, I
Sue is asking, will you blend in the back also, or just do one solid color?
no, usually I do one solid color and I don't know from I don't know in the beginning which color I put in the back, but usually one of the colors from the furniture, definitely. So yeah, I'm not gonna try to make it to go further with this, because I really don't want to now to take away the paint from the furniture. I think it's okay for the hand number for the coat number one. I really think it's fine. I like it. And then I will let it dry. And I don't know how what time is it. I have no idea what time is it.
10:56.
Then, oh, okay. So shall we do another the other side? I let you vote, guys, ladies. I can stay 15, 20 more minutes to make also the other side. And if you want, I can keep this piece and we can continue working on it next week in another live, because I don't have this one is not sold. This I made only for you, and I will sell it afterwards, hopefully in the store that hopefully I will have soon. So I can keep it for you, and we can do it together next week. So just let me know if you
Samantha said yes, please.
yes please, so we
Sue
continue
said
it.
yes, please.
Oh, great.
And tell us what you will do to the top.
Thank you. Good question. I don't know. The because actually the top is in very bad condition. And I cannot sand too much because this is not real wood. As you can see, this is really not wood. It's a board, prefabricated board.
Brandy says, this looks gorgeous. Great job.
Brandy, what Brandy?
Brush by Brandy.
No! She's watching me! Oh my god! Oh my gosh, Brandy, thank you! Thank you, thank you! Look, 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 look! 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 Hey! It's the first coat. Next week we do the rest. Oh my gosh! Thank you for watching, Brandy. Just a second, because someone asked me what I'm doing with the top, and I want to show you what I think I will do with the top. And I think I will go with this silk paper. I know someone told me, oh, this is not silk paper. This is just ordinary wallpaper. And I said, no, this is not an ordinary wallpaper. This is a very expensive wallpaper, first of all. And I don't know, Vali, tell me if you can really see. Yeah, so it has texture. And this texture is not paper. This is really silk. So this is a wallpaper. Indeed, it's a wallpaper, but it has silk insertion. And at least here in Europe, we don't call it wallpaper, we call it silk paper. So, yeah, probably I will go, let's go for a vote. Because if we are gonna do this piece only live, then it's worthy to let the girls and the gentlemen decide. I used this silk paper quite a lot, not quite a lot, I used it also for two other furniture. Can you see also the side and the face, the front?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I want to go with this, like this. What do you think?
Okay.
I think.
Oh, you're gonna make me cry, you're so sweet. Real life furniture by MK says beautiful colors, you're beautiful.
Brandy, I just said, I think you are not live, you're not watching. When I said that I was a stalker, I've been watching your videos like obsessively, probably a million times, I think. And I was telling to the girls that I was literally watching you and I was stopping the video and going 10 seconds before, you know, in back and watching your hand and how you were keeping the brush and how much you were touching and feathering the furniture. So thank you for everything I know about blending. Thank you. Okay, so yeah, what do you think about this?
Gorgeous paper, but for me, no paper on the top, says Samantha.
Yeah.
Janet says, I have the same paper, wouldn't have thought to put it on top of a dresser. Brandy says, gorgeous texture, very rich and regal looking.
Yeah, exactly. I didn't want to put something on top also, but the problem is that the top is quite damaged. And as I said, it's not real wood, it's a prefabricated board. And I cannot sand too much because I'm afraid that I will take this varnish away. And I don't want to do that. So I prefer to put something nice. And besides this, because this is quite a narrow piece, so probably it will end up on a hallway, on somewhere in an entrance. And then on this top, people will put keys, people will put, I don't know, all kind of, you know, things that can scratch. So because it will be probably a heavily used piece, I would put silk paper for a more durable finish in time to make it more, to make it more durable. Why do I try to invent words when they are already invented? I'm talking a lot. I'm talking a lot because I don't know.
Christine paint and stencil the top.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, that's not a bad idea, indeed. And I have some nice stencils on the side, by the way, on the sides.
That makes sense, save the paper for specialty.
Ah, yeah, it's quite an expensive paper, indeed. And for the sides, on after we finish, I want to play with these two absolutely beautiful transfers. This one is a new one, the cherry blossom transfer, and I love this pink. So if I will not go on top with the steel paper, definitely I'm gonna use parts of this one. And for the sides, I definitely want to use the lace transfer, which is so elegant, and it really fits very well the front, which is quite I don't know. Can you move the camera? Yeah, thank you, camera guy. So they have pretty much the same patterns. So I think on the sides, this one, which is silver, will really go super elegant. But that will, I don't know, that will make me, I will have to mix the gilding waxes and not to keep too.
Just use a texture paper and paint it after. That's what I do when the tops are damaged.
Okay, you mean also like a wallpaper, right? That's what you mean by textured paper. I don't know if I know exactly what you mean. Yeah, those are also, thank you, very good ideas. Also stenciling, yeah, I've been thinking also about stenciling, but I don't know about stenciling. I'm not a big fan of stenciling. I don't know why. Some people like it, some people don't. I'm not a big fan. I never get a nice finish with the silk paper, with the stencil. I don't know why.
Samantha says, yes, a textured wallpaper.
Uh-huh, okay. The simple ones, white ones that we use on the wall, probably, and then to paint. Yeah, that's a very smart idea. Thank you very much, Samantha. That's really super smart, indeed. Okay, so let's go and let's finish this side as well.
Sue says, for the future, would love to hear your husband repeating the questions.
Oh my gosh, Brandy, I mean, you've made my day already. Come on, please. Thank you so much. You are so lovely. Thank you so much. I've been scared to death to get to this live, I have to admit. And yeah, Brandy, you know, we talked already and you encouraged me. Thank you very much. I was super afraid. I don't know why, but I was like, phew. And also today I had a very busy day in the office and I couldn't get back home in time because I had to go to an event with a customer. I've been to WTA tennis we have here in Luxembourg now, the Luxembourg WTA tournament. Yeah, exactly. So I had to go with customer there, and I was like driving like crazy in the city to reach home because the piece was not cleaned. And when I came home and I noticed that it was full of cigarette smoke, I was like, oh my gosh, I have no piece to paint tonight. But thanks to White Lightning, which is such an amazing product, I cleaned it, and also the smell went away, and it's now super fresh and super, super, super clean. Yeah, some pieces are so dirty. Oh gosh. That's why probably inside the drawers I will also paint, because When I put silk paper inside, if I put silk paper inside only on the bottom, anyway, I disinfect all the pieces with white lining. Then I put a disinfectant. I also, when I buy them, I place anti-insect treatment for against the worms and everything. I really take care of these things. It's very important how we are preparing the furniture and how we are keeping them, because these are going to some people's homes, and we want to be here this year and next year and in 5 years, in 10 years, and we don't want to have customers complaining, oh, I bought something from you and then it had worms. So I always, when I buy something, I spray immediately anti-insect on them, and then I disinfect them with the disinfectants and also with the white lining. That's the let's say the heavy one, because it really makes this how do you say, it's almost like you would sand it. It's like a light sanding. This is what I feel that white lining is doing, because I can see that the shine goes away, which is amazing, because it really prepares the piece in a very, very good way. Yeah, so do not hurry and take your time and prepare the furniture and clean them and disinfect them. This is such an important step, very, very important step. I think it's the most important step. Yeah, so if the pieces are really nasty, then I also paint inside drawers. And anyway, I place the silk paper or decoupage paper, or depends. Yeah, so we are starting to blend now. Again, very softly, barely touching the furniture. Very, very gently. Okay. And then, and again, it's very important, especially when we blend, always it's important to not load too much paint on the brush. You will never see me taking more than this. And I have to admit that in the past, when I started to paint, I was doing the mistake to take more paint on the brush. And it was, especially when I started to blend, it was very difficult to blend because it was too much volume of paint on the furniture. And it was really very hard to blend all that massive amount of paint. So you'd better dip twice the brush in the can rather than have too much. So don't load too much.
Sue says, love that you create a great foundation and do beautiful painting.
Thank you so much. You are so cute and so kind, guys. You've been so helpful. Thank you for joining. Why am I this? If you want to, let's say, to make the blending a little bit easier, it's very important, or it's easy. Let's say it's really easy if you do the also moves like this and like this, so horizontally and vertically. So now I really don't have any more paint on this brush. Yeah, so I'm just going into all directions like this, and I leave this aside, and then with the clean oval, I come and I start to feather the furniture. It's a little bit dry. I have to put a little bit of mist. I'm talking too much, and I let the paint too much on the furniture, which is not good.
Hi.
Hello, Chris. Hello. Thank you for joining. Ah, no, come on, what is this? Oh my gosh, thank you, Chris, for joining. Thank you so much, baby. I'm still saving that furniture to paint it together. It's in my storage. I don't paint it. I'm waiting for you. We have to paint it together. Thank you for joining, Chris. This is so cute. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And Brandy. And oh my gosh, I'm so honored. Two of the greatest artists I'm following. They are following me now. They're watching me. Oh my gosh. Thank you. Yeah, so for the first hand, we are just going slowly, and we try to make this line between colors as much as possible invisible. That's the goal, is to have no line in between colors. At least this is my goal. So, and it
says the whole crew is here.
Ah! Yeah, exactly. Thank you, crew. We have such an amazing crew. Come on. Thank you so much, girls. Yeah, and when we do this, then we just make that line disappear. Anyway, this is the first coat, yeah? So we don't want to go crazy because we just risk to take the paint away from the furniture. And that's not what we want, but we want to create this ombre already and to make the line disappear. I don't like the line. I like that visually the piece looks like it has a light inside. So that's what I'm trying to create now, a light that is lightening the furniture.
This almost looks like it's glowing.
Yes, exactly. Thank you. Yes, exactly. That's what I'm trying to make. I'm trying to make it like a light.
Brandy says, watching and eating carrot cake. What are the good things in life?
Carrot cake. We have cheesecake, yeah, but we have low carbs. Cheesecake. We have a food artist. That's what her name is, a food artist, and she's doing this. Oh, she's doing this amazing cakes, low carb, low fat, low whatever, and they are super tasty. I mean, that's the whole thing. And we make every Friday. We order with her a cake. Last week we had a chocolate one, and this week we have a blueberry cheesecake. Oh my gosh, and it's so good. Yeah, carrot cake. Oh, okay, you gave me an idea. Oh, carrot cake. Oh, that was so good. When is the last time when we had carrot cake?
You can order for next week.
Yeah, I will order, yeah, one for next week. So my glowing ombre, I think it's, I'm fine with what it looks like right now. I'm okay. It's definitely not perfect. It's not going to be perfect now, but next coat will really define all this, and I will also redo the front. Thank you for the girl that told me what to do and what direction to go. That was really a very good suggestion. So as you can see, I started initially, I wanted to go with the midnight sky here and with the peacock here, and then to go up with the Dixie Bell blue. But I had a very good input from one of you, which was great, and I changed here on the third or on the second drawer, and that was to put the light in the middle, and that's why we put also on the sides the same. What I'm gonna do when this gets a little bit dry, I will take out the drawers and I will also paint the frame, because as you can see, I will definitely not leave it like that. Yeah. So I will take all the drawers and I will unify this, and I will make the blending also on these small sides that remained unpainted. And then we decided together that we continue this piece again in another life. Yes, in another life, I said. No, in another life. Yes, and we will do it probably next week. I'm not sure if we can make it also Friday, but I think we should be okay. And then we finish the blending. And then you can also help me to choose together the transfer that we will use. So I think I'm going to be ready. Oh, gosh, 1 hour and something already. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks to everyone. Thank you very much for watching. Really, it means the world to me. And I really hope that you liked what we did together. And I hope you will join me also in the next live, not live, in the next live, when we will finish this piece and when we will decide what we will do with the top. Definitely, I'm not going to paint it and leave it like this because it's really... it's really not in good shape, and I don't want to have this. I cannot let it go away from my atelier in this condition. We are gonna wash the brushes. Normally, if I know that I'm gonna paint tomorrow, for instance, I will put them in a wet microfiber cloth like this, and I will spray water on like this. And then this one, I will put it in a plastic bag. Also, this one I know from Brandy. Thank you, Brandy. Thank you. And I will keep it in the fridge, but only if I do it tomorrow, which is not gonna be the case. So I'm gonna go and I'm gonna wash them. And what I want to show you, one more thing that I want to show you before I finish this live, because Dixie Belle just created now another amazing product. And just a second. And this amazing product, I mean, when I say amazing, we need to invent another word. This is the invention. This cleaner for the brushes. This is, oh my gosh, I will explain you what it means. So if you see this brush, if you see the handler, you can, handle. If you see this handle, I'm also taking English lessons here. If you didn't understand, my husband is teaching me English. Yeah. So it's a very old brush. I have it. I think it has over. I think it has one year, around 1 year. And you see from the color. Look how changed the color of the handle. Is handle is, yeah, so it's an old brush. But what I want you to see is that the bristles are super clean, are just as clean as the new one. And this is because I just washed it with this product, which is amazing. So what I do, I put in a small glass, but I don't use plastic. I don't know why. I'm afraid to put in plastic. I put it in glass, and I will take a small video maybe, and I will show you, and then I leave it there for a couple of hours, and then I'm coming with a small how do you call that thing that you are brushing the hair? I don't know. You know?
Huh?
Comb. Okay. And I clean the bristles. So this is how it looks after I washed it. It's an amazing product. So if you forget your brushes out for a day or something, then you have the savior here. It's really a game changer. This product is amazing, amazing. Okay, so I've been talking and talking and talking. So hopefully we will be able to meet again next Friday. I will see how the arrangements can be done. Thank you very much, everyone, for watching. Thank you.
Great job. It's beautiful. You are a great teacher.
Thank you.
Light all sounds. same. I'm not sure if we get the point.
Yeah.
This says your English is perfect.
Oh.
Languages, you have to think before you say things of what language you need to speak, and you are doing amazing.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining. Thank you for asking questions. Thank you for not letting me alone speak here by myself. I was afraid of that. Thank you so much to Dixie Bell for giving me this opportunity to let me be in front of you tonight and to work together with you on this piece. Thank you, my dear husband, for being so supportive always and for being the... yeah,
the
most amazing English teacher in the world. Thank you, everyone. See you next week. I love you. I love you. Thank you. Bye.